For those forced to breathe in toxic air every day, it can seem that little's being done to address this issue. So let's talk about a little bit more. David Wallace Wells, this is something that you've written extensively about. So are we taking pollution seriously enough, do you think?
The short answer is absolutely not. It seems to me to be among the biggest public health and environmental crises of our time. In some ways, a bigger problem even than climate change. The mortality statistics are overwhelming. Most data suggests at least 7 million people, perhaps as many as 10 or more million people a year dying from air pollution, most of that from the burning of fossil fuels. That is an unfathomable amount of death and much more suffering besides. I think we're not doing nearly enough, in part because many of us living in places like the UK and the US don't regard the humanity of people living in places like India adequately, but also because we regard the status quo in which we ourselves in our relatively clean air are suffering as acceptable simply because it is the status quo, and don't think about what kind of a better, cleaner, healthier future we could be building, and then also a more prosperous one if we took the opportunity to more rapidly transition off of those deadly fuels and into a much greener, cleaner future.
And Dave, I can see you nodding there, and I think you've got some personal experience. You feel that you've been affected by pollution, don't you?
Oh, yes, I have. I have grown up in an area of where most kids in primary schools have asthma, and I grew up thinking that was totally normal, which it isn't. I'm living in an area where we have an incinerator, and we watch the incinerator burn over a community that's mostly populated by black and brown people of working class backgrounds. This is the reality of air pollution. It's not just something that affects our health, but it affects our developmental stages. It affects communities as a whole, and the fact that it's allowed to be continued for so long, it's disgusting. In places like, for example, in Lewisham in London, it's 6 times over the legal levels of air pollution. It's literally illegal to breathe the air that we're breathing currently, and we are not even the worst. When is it going to be enough? When are enough people going to die for governments to care?
Well, yes, and that's interesting, isn't it? You quoted that figure from the World Health Organization, David, saying that around 7 million people die from air pollution annually. But as Dave's pointed out, it's not just in some of those poorer developing countries. It is also in big, wealthy cities as well. So do you think that people are waking up to this? They're beginning to?
I think they're beginning to. A lot of the scariest research is now just a few years old, and it tends to take a little while for that kind of stuff to sort of circulate and percolate and begin to change public opinion and public policy. I do think the more we talk about it, the more we note it, the more alarmed we'll be. And I do think the research is going to continue moving very much in this direction. The World Health Organization, just a couple months ago, changed its threshold, the standard that it says is safe. They cut it in half, which means it used to be the case that 90% of the world was living in places with dangerously polluted air. Now it's something closer to 99%, which means almost nobody is safe. And in fact, the researchers doing that work say possibly even that safe threshold isn't safe. They just haven't really done the work yet on the lower levels of air pollution to know, but they suspect that as it was with lead pollution, no level of air pollution will be safe at all. And we'll still be seeing death from pollution, but also, as Dave was pointing out, developmental problems, cognitive problems, behavioral problems produced in part, at least, from this pollution, which is an elective problem. We could be burning much less fossil fuel. We could be burning much less farmland. These are choices we make in part through policy, which are killing at least 7. And you know, the figures I trust are more like 10 million people a year, which is, again, just an absolutely staggering figure. It means 100 million deaths a decade. It means 400 million deaths in my lifetime. That is the kind of thing that we should be orienting an entire moral politics around, not one that we should be treating as an environmental afterthought.